The bright orange and black wings with white dots is one of the most noticeable butterflies found in New Hampshire. The monarch butterfly. But there is concern that is growing over this insect's fate.
The monarch butterfly has declined by 90% since the 1990s when they first started counting populations in the winter in Mexico.
Each fall, New Hampshire's monarchs begin their migration south. It's during this migration that a study is underway to learn more about this majestic insect.
We're looking for monarch butterflies so we can start to answer the question of where exactly they migrate, what pathways. We know a general sense, but with this novel technology, we might be able to see that with a little bit more detail.
The technology is called the Motus Wildlife Tracking System, which was paid for through a U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service's Competitive State Wildlife Grant. In late 2020, one of the first Motus antennas in New Hampshire was installed in Stoddard on a piece of property owned by the Harris Center for Conservation Education.
It just so happened that we're a land trust, we're also an environmental education organization, and we also coordinate conservation research and citizen science projects. And so, of course, it fits in with conservation research because that's exactly what it is. So it kind of fits all the pieces for us. The land that we're standing on right now is our Granite Lake Headwaters property in Stoddard. We protected this a few years ago now.
It's a series of ham radio antennas that are just listening for a certain frequency. And so this project specifically is building these stations that are listening towards each other. And so their detection distances are overlapping. So as soon as a migrating animal with one of these tags passes beyond that, you know, listening fence, it's detected.
People have been tagging wildlife for a really long time to track their local movements, maybe their breeding behaviors, and tracking of butterflies with this type of technology is very new and cutting edge. And as you can imagine, it's because of their really small size. So they've just been able to build a transmitter that can be used on this tiny organism.
This year was the first year that the 0.13 gram nano pins were available.
29.
So we have two different sized nano tags. It's a nano tag and a nano pin. The lighter one is 0.13 and the larger one is 0.23. And so the difference there is really just the battery life.
Yep, that should be the last one.
Good.
But in order to tag monarchs, one must catch them.
We'll probably be covering our ground multiple times, so there's no bad place to start. Happy hunting.
It's a two-person operation, and it's like doing surgery on the outside of these little insects that are so delicate, but one person gets them in their hands, shows the abdomen, and another person puts glue on the tag, and then it affixes right on their abdomen.
Once the tags are attached, the butterflies spend the night to make sure they're okay. The next morning, they're released to continue on their journey.
The butterfly lives 9 months out of the year, flying around, being active and breeding, and that makes it very susceptible to a variety of climate issues. Pesticides have been an issue, use of commercial agriculture and getting all the weeds out of agricultural stands, which includes milkweed, unfortunately, and nectar plants that they need. They're facing numerous challenges, and we're trying to hit all of those at once.
The hope with this new technology is for biologists and conservationists to better understand what needs to be done to keep the monarch butterfly flying for the next generation.